Regarding to the submissions of assignments or quizzes, so please do not worry about the deadlines. So we told in the second meeting itself. See, these deadlines, what we have just put on the quiz and assignments, are basically to make you to be engaged with the subject. So that will make you to at least have some kind of consistency in going through the course properly. So anyway, all those quizzes of even quiz 1, quiz 2, quiz 3, we are going to extend the dates. So maybe another up to September 30th, all the dates will be extended for all the quizzes and for the assignments too. So that we are announcing today. So you make a note that do not worry about the deadlines, that if you have crossed it, do not worry. But the reattempting will not be permitted. So it's not that n number of times you can reattempt a particular component or a particular test or a quiz. So if you are attempting, that will be the one attempt you have to make sure that you'll be completing. Sometimes maybe because there may be some settings which we are not completed, so one or two students may have some multiple number of attempts. Maybe immediately. So that we'll correct it if the setting was not done properly. So all the assignments and the quizzes dates will be extended up to September 30. So at least up to this month end. So we'll extend it. So do not worry about those deadlines. So yeah, that is one thing. And coming to the next. Regarding this curl command, some of you get confused about this terminology. What is this? Can you please tell the exact difference between headers placed by curl in the request and the headers found in the response? Okay. So the doubt here is, what is that you are going to place it and what is that you are going to get regarding the CURL? CURL stands for command URL. Command URL is what I discussed in the video. So let me just give you another example here. Open my command. You can open your command prompt from your screen. So in the command prompt, suppose you are giving a command. The command is related to the curl. That is command URL, CURL. And I'm giving something like this. Just see here, one command I'm giving, okay. I'm giving a URL, let it be even this. Okay. This is one example. Just understand this command here now. So the command statement is like this. The command itself is following the curl. You give an option here, get the interactive one. You are getting the interaction with, what is that? There is something you want to like to know, HTTP2. So you want to find out if there is an HTTP2 headers are there in this web address. The web address is, or the web URL is, https://www.uhod.ac.in. So in this URL, the uniform resource locator, in this web URL, you are looking for one particular option. What option? That option is basically, what is the HTTP2 header contains? If at all, if HTTP2 is there in this web address. So, you know, there are different types of HTTPs. HTTP1, HTTP1.1, HTTP2, HTTP3. HTTP3 is the latest version. So the difference between HTTP1 and HTTP1, if you might have seen my videos and the slides, you'll clearly understand what is the difference between HTTP 1 and HTTP 1.1. Extension to HTTP 1.1 is the HTTP 2. Okay, let me just complete this curl command. So curl, what are the things that are related to HTTP 2 with respect to this URL? If you press enter now, let us see what is going to happen. Let us see. So I just pressed enter. So I'm just waiting here. I just clicked enter button from this command. Just hold on, you'll get some response here. Definitely you'll get some response from the one. Now you, once you enter like this, it means the request has been sent. You'll get the response here. Well, even if it is wrong also, you'll get some response. So you just enter the command with the curl. Now you see the response what you got here. The response here says that curl, the curl command, could not resolve host HTTP2 because there is no HTTP2. That's what it could not find out. But what it has found out is it has got HTTP 1.1. And you know what is this code 200 indicates? It means that particular 200 indicates that web resource is available on the server with this web resource, which one? HTTP 1.1. So, and what is a server? This is a server. The on this particular website, the server they are following is Apache. And you'll see there are other certain important information here, like the content security policy, upgrade, connection, cache control, expires, so on and so forth information. This particular entire, this is the content type. Content type is a text HTML, the character set, the encoding they are followed is UTF-8. So you got a lot of information here. So this is all response that you get it from the curl command. So this curl command, this is a response, and this is the request that you have made here. So what we asked for is HTTP2. What are all the things related to HTTP2 of this particular web address? But you do not get HTTP2, but you got a response with HTTP 1.1. It means that website is having only 1.1. So this is a response, and this is the, whatever you ask is the header. This is what your, this command. The command that you ask is basically is that particular thing that you required for. That is HTTP2 you asked, but you got only HTTP 1.1. This is the response. So here, do not confuse between the headers placed by the URL. So the what is that I have placed here? I have placed this particular command. In the command, I place this particular option, that is the HTTP header I placed here, and the headers found in the response. So when I got the response, I got the HTTP response is this one, this particular value. So for this particular one example here, that's what you need to understand. This is one which you placed, and this is the one which you got it. That is what here means the response, and this is what you mean by request. So that is one doubt. So not only this, when you pass this command, when you write this command, this curl hyphen capital I followed by whatever the options you write it here, those are all the things that you are placing in the header. That's called the request that you are making from your side. So those things can be like, what is the content type? If you want to know what is the content type from this web address, means the web content, whether it is an HTML content or whether it has got some text or not, whether it has got some audio files or some, whether you got a video file, something like this. Those are the different types of contents. So all these left sides, whatever you see, this colon on the left side, colon values, all this can be queried from this command. So when you query with respect to this left side attributes, that is what you place that headers. You call it as, you are placing them in the request. And when you get the response, the right side value, these are all the values that you got the response from the server. So that is the difference between the request, you, when you are placing the commands, that is a request you made by the curl, and you are getting the responses that does found here, this particular example. That is one another doubt. The another doubt is, In assignment 3, first question, should we use map tag for world and Indian maps? Yes, see, I told regarding to the assignment 3 questions, means this exercise is for integrated MTech students. So the first question is basically, whenever a user clicks from the world map, your country is to be zoomed, something like this. Zooming means country has to be selected. Whenever you select a state from the country like our India, that particular state has to be selected. So I have clearly mentioned, when we click on a state to display information in a new way, means it will create 28 different HTML pages. See here carefully. That's what your creativity goes, your idea goes in that particular direction. If you want to create like that, yes, it is possible, but it will take a long time. Simply, you are creating 28 pages. But if you just click here, you can simply display a 2 lines or 3 lines of information. So that you have to see what you have to display it on the anchor tag. It is all up to you to design your web page, whether you want to go separate pages or just display the information whenever user clicks is your design, your idea. So we like to keep it open to you. We don't want to restrict how you create another 20 pages. We don't want to say it is up to you. Of course, it is a long time. Time consumes if you are going to create more pages. If you can just simply provide the information, the 2-3 lines information only I ask you to provide, you can as well provide with your tag attribute values only. So that is another doubt. Okay. And so regarding to the assignment to the option to send if this assignment, then sir, how to send trace file along the assignment to the trace file. That's what you are getting. See, I have given you how to find the trace file with your curl command. You can find out the trace file. So copy that, whatever the trace file is there, copy that output of the trace file into your assignment file and just send as an assignment file. There's no need to send them separately. So as a single file only, always you submit as a single file, not multiple files, please. Error in test submission. I have submitted the test. Regarding, see, when you're writing quizzes, something like this question, when you're giving the answers here, if there is a space constraints or there is space is also a character, that's why the string matching will not happen properly. So anyway, I have removed the restriction, but if you're still facing the problem, let me know, because I would like to know whether you are able to write some statements or so. That's what one or two sample questions I have given on the quiz here, to make you to enter some lines of text, and we'll see how that module is working for us. So we also need to check for various options in how to evaluate it. So if at all some problems like this, even if you give the answer correct and it says wrong, you do not worry about that one. You just send me the messages. We'll give this marks, because new phone, maybe some space characters are not matching here, because I also given this is what I have given the answer and there is also matching. So it's exactly the characters has to be matched, including the spaces. That is not always possible. So after I look into this question, then I remove that constraint there. So I hope others are able to now submit it properly. Yeah, this is what I could get some of those queries. Maybe if you have some doubts here, now you can just pose it on, please.
Hello, sir. I think your mic is off, sir.
Oh, sorry, my mic is muted. Sorry. Yeah. So regarding to the assignment 3, I was talking about the assignment 3 first question. So please look to the question again. I'm reading it. So create a web page that will have separate links to show map of India and world. It means India map is one and the world map is the other one. It means there are two maps here. So map of India and world map. When a user will open a map of India, you have to create links to display the information of each state. So when the user clicks the map of India, obviously Indian map contains different states. So your 29 states, it means 29 states, you have 29 different links, hyperlinks are there for the map. So you can put each hyperlink on the map itself. Only the positions are going to be different. Position means placement of the hyperlinks. So whenever a user clicks a particular link, the create links to display the information of each state, that whenever a user clicks that link, that particular state's information should be displayed. And that information, how you want to display it, is highlighted in the map in a separate window or a document. The information should be brief, that is not more than 3 to 4 sentences. So if you want to create a separate window for each hyperlink, yes, you can create. That's what in the previous student's question is, you want to have to create 29 pages or 29 windows or documents will come. If you don't want to create those 29 pages separately, you can as well provide, when you click, you can provide those 3 to 4 sentences at the click of that button itself. So it is all up to your design, to design. So whenever similarly, when user will open a world map, show the list of countries on clicking the image in a new window, something like that. Whenever he clicks, user clicks on the world map of a particular country, that country has to be shown on a new window. Or if you want, you can just zoom it up. So nowadays you can see technology has improved. You can zoom in, zoom out, because you are not studying bootstrapping. That kind of user interface or user interactivity will not come very much flexible to you. But what I suggest you is, since if you are a beginner and you know you are doing the web pages, you do this work. It is just from the scratch you are doing, so little bit laborious works are there. So better you do the laborious works in the learning stage itself. So you can create those pages and try to incorporate. If you don't want to create, you can use the tag, attribute tags, and you can put display the information properly. You can as well complete that. So that is a doubt for this. I hope it is clear, Tarun, and for others also.
Sir, but there are many more countries, no, sir, nearly 128.
Countries, that's what I'm telling you, you can just sample. Okay, you mean to say for all countries, yes, see, that's what you need to understand here. The point to understood, make you to have some clarity is that when you are designing web pages and if you are providing information for each document, yes, all those web pages are to be made available for different purposes. So if you are going to 128 countries, 129 or 160, it all depends on you. The idea is, how do you minimize those works? Is the creativity comes into picture for you. If you want to just display that 2 or 3 lines of each country name, the country name, the capital city is this, something like that, you can just put, or latitude, longitude of this is this, that click of that button, that is enough for the world map. So how do you present to the user is what? So why we make you to understand here is because there will be requirements later when you design your web pages for your company or an organization. So obviously, for there are some departments are there, computer science, physics, chemistry, mathematics. So you have to develop or design and develop web pages for each department. So it is all because it is all a collection of repository. You are all your collection of documents. Web itself, the meaning of web is collection of all documents.
Sir, Can we take continents instead of countries in case of world?
See, I'm not restricting to you. So if you have to understand, means that's the point actually. The question problem is, it is always, whenever you design and develop, it is always a laborious process for a web applications. So if at all somebody, student, can come out with an idea about how do you minimize, that is what, how do you minimize all that laborious process, that is more welcome. If you can go for the only continents, okay, is acceptable. It's not a very big thing. You have to understand how you can make hyperlink and how you can navigate from one web page to another web page, or how one from one document to another document, how do you go? The basic idea is that, but when there are more pages are there, how do you go about it? It depends on your logic only again.
Yes,
Any other doubts, please? So the PHP material, I will keep it maybe after 2 3 days. I don't want you make it to very hurriedly go all these things. Please understand the JavaScript programming. JavaScript is the most important thing for your web applications. Please, your JavaScript, even HTML, CSS are okay, but the JavaScript is the most crucial part, which I feel for you. Why? Because tomorrow, when you are applying artificial intelligence and machine learning algorithms onto your web pages, JavaScript is going to be most useful. So let me just tell you, I am just preparing one book. So that book is basically this only. Then I will share the book, almost is getting ready. I'm giving it to the publisher. So that is, book is basically AI in browser. We want to how we can put artificial intelligence on the browser. So this I will share to you. If you see these examples, your neural networks and your Java, it is all about JavaScripts only, using various libraries. So this, let me just show you some examples how you can run your JavaScripts on the browsers. Just, it is only for informative only. So how the artificial intelligence and machine learning algorithms can be run on this one. Anyway, this copy I can share you, because I am the only author, I can share you with you all this. So this is a small example which I'm running on my browser only, along with some other elements. So even examples I can share to you all. But first, complete the basics of a JavaScript. That's what I have given in my slides to you. Once you complete that basics, then I can share this material. You can work it on that one to run more examples here. These are all the human pose classification. Basically, this is all with the JavaScripts only. You can run your neural network. This is what artificial intelligence technique. Those people who understand, means know at least about what is neural network, they'll understand here. So you can run this neural network on the neural network problem can be run on your browser itself. So this is what the outputs looks here. So you can realize your NAND gates, your all these examples. These are all basically can run on your JavaScript. Simple JavaScripts, that's all. See, like these are P5 and ML5. ML5 stands for machine learning. So there is one library called ml5.min.js. It is basically a JavaScript file. P stands for processing, like your graphical user interfaces, graphics. That is one library. So you can, using machine learning, you can find the key points of your body. You can find out what the person's, where the, how the key points are functioning and all. So I'm doing some applications here. That's why you can find out what are all these. From the photo itself, you can identify what are all your key points. So these are all basically JavaScripts only. This is the advancements of JavaScript, the latest thing, what people are doing. So basically, this is human pose classification. Like this, there are so many things are there for JavaScripts. So in the olden days, what people have to do when they were doing is writing the machine learning and artificial intelligence algorithms on GPU systems, graphical processing units. like on your big machines. But nowadays, this machine learning and AI, you can run on your own laptops, on your own browser, on your own mobile phone. So the technology is much advanced here. That's what you can see, that advancements of technology. But to understand that advancements, please, you have to understand the basics. That's what the JavaScript is all about. So do practice the JavaScript. Once you practice the JavaScripts, you will be very much confident. You can run your AI algorithms, that is your machine learning and deep learning algorithms, on your own computers, on your own laptops, on your own mobile phones, you can run. On your own IoT devices, you can run this. That is the advantage of those things. I will share my material to you because I am sending it to the publisher. Once that book is published, then I can share my material to you. Don't worry about that. I can share. So that is just, I want to show you that is the advancement of the JavaScript only. Yeah. Any other doubts, please? Everybody has to practice with their own programs. So once you complete your practicing, definitely I'm confident that you will do good jobs on your web designs. I think that some of you still not yet started this JavaScript. Maybe you are doing the HTML and CSS. Okay, do it slowly. We are not in a very hurry. So these fundamental topics will be done very slowly only. Coolly, you have to do it. Understand how you can develop, design and develop your web pages. So we will not give any, of course, there is only time constraints are there, puts from Q8 and all these things. They're only just make you to be on the toes. Means make you to go through the things regularly so that you will be having some kind of consistency in understanding those topics. If you just give an infinite time, then people will take it very lazily. That's why that is the only problem. So we keep on extending those days. But I have seen on the assignment one, the submissions which are done after 2 days or 3 days also, they are there. We keep on a record of all those things, please. So please try to avoid as much as you can. Don't just purposely prolong your tasks. If there is really a problem, definitely we are there for you to help. Yeah, any doubts, please? Next week, I will during the interactive meeting, definitely I will show you how you can put how you can run your AI and machine learning algorithms on your browser itself. using JavaScript, right? Because by the time I hope people may complete some small exercises related to JavaScript, so they'll know what is a JavaScript and how to use it. So that examples I will show you how we can run it during the interactive session. This is not related to our subject, just an advancements of JavaScript that will give you an idea. Yes, Parikshitra. Yeah, tell me, you are trying to ask something.
No, sir. I was just.
Yeah, because see, let me reiterate. See, we are going on an asynchronous mode. So during this 1, 2, or 3 hours of week, as we mentioned earlier, we are not going to take any classes as such. If you have not understood any topic of whatever the video presentations we have made, we will like to clarify you and we'll make you to understand whatever the best way you can do it. See, ours is actually, that's what our motto is, to go in asynchronous mode. It means we already put the material to you, the videos and PDFs or PPTs. So please go through those videos and the PDFs. And whatever the references we are giving, please go through that books. Sir, how is security maintained in P2P system? Yeah, security in P2P system is basically, see, security means what is security? Can may I know if security is basically a very big topic? This question is related from Nitin Sai. Yeah, so what is P2P? P2P stands for peer-to-peer. So here, don't think that security with respect to client-server and P2P is going to be different. Okay. P2P is basically you are getting. It is this, yeah, peer-to-peer. Yes, that's what peer-to-peer. See, the same issues will be there. Like what you see it in the client server also, you'll have the same kind of problems with the peer-to-peer also. Whatever security features are there for client server, that same, more or less the same security features for peer-to-peer. It is not as different from client server. So when you are very much specific in security maintained in P2P system, that's what I was just wondering. It is not as different from client server. Same in client server, what kind of security systems means. So data is transferred in packets. Yes, of course, data is transferred in your packets only. Ultimately, see, don't think that only TCP/IP is what your client server goes and all about. Once again, let me reiterate, what is a server? Let tell me, make you to clear, have some clarity. Server is a person or server is a thing which can serve for whatever the request you are making. In peer-to-peer, there is no concept called as server because all of them are servers and all of them are requesters. So data transfer, only thing is the storage of information in the client server is present. The storage of information is your web documents all are present at one particular place, that one particular server. Whereas in P2P, not all documents are going to present at one particular place. They can be shared. That's why it is called scalable. You are going to put some information in one system, put other information in another system. It is going to be distributed. Your information is distributed across many systems in your P2P. That is one way of architecture. That is a network. That's what is one type of architecture. So, to understand, make it to clear, P2P is basically your BitTorrent files. We call it as BitTorrent files. Those people who are downloading some softwares or some downloading some kind of software tools and softwares and other web resources on the internet using torrent files. They may know easily when you click that torrent file for downloading, that file is getting downloaded from various sources, not from a single place. It means that information is actually present in this. It is distributed in different places and you are getting that particular packets of information. So that is what in networking terminology is. So security, same vulnerabilities like your distributed DOS attacks, whatever you see it in client server is also present in your P2P also. So it has to make many requests through many nodes. Won't that affect the response time? Yes, of course. Yes, because they are not designated to a particular server, because the requests have been distributed. That's why if you see why that circular DHT has got problem, because many messages are to be exchanged. If there are thousands of computers are there, thousands of messages are to be exchanged. To overcome that one, the hashing technique, distributed hashing technique through cards, that's what the minimizing the message. Like that is only one of the methods. Like that, there are many methods are there. So people do apply these torrent files. They do apply searching for data, where exactly the data for corresponding key is located. They go for various searching mechanisms. So people are in need of this. You can also keep your own ideas. How do you retrieve the data from a peer-to-peer system in a more efficient manner? So, because this is an introductory topic, we are not going to the protocols and the methods into more depth on this topic. So just because this to give you an idea that there is a peer-to-peer system and there is a client server, and the difference between those two is what this is an introductory topic. So the response times, yes, network performance issues, networks, performance and the delays and the throughputs and the jitters, all of these are network parameters, performance parameters. Definitely there is a lot of effects are there. It all differs from method to method you incorporate in the P2P system. But today servers are very fast, and how is P2P better than client server? Yes, today what happens is technology is much advanced in the hardware as well as on the software part. Well, it's not like the olden days. So when the internet era has begun around 2000 in that year, that is basically the internet after the Y2K problem is over. The internet technologies are much advanced here, much efficient techniques. That's what now today you see artificial intelligence, the intelligence part, intelligent methods are now applied onto your at the client level itself, at the browser level itself. So these are all advancements. So that is advancements means the techniques are getting advanced. So those systems are this P2P, because they are distributed and they are been there is a mechanism to retrieve the files very fastly. They don't depend on the server because the server load will be very much high. That is the advantage of getting the distributed computing. The P2P go with the distributed nature. That is a very fast in retrieving and storing the information and searching the information. That's why it is better. To some extent, for some applications, it is better than client server. But for some applications, like suppose you go for a medical application or an agricultural application, and all, they are preferred for client server only. They don't go for only P2P. So for some applications where there are only just data exchanges all the time, some data need not be processed. For those applications, P2P is better. But if the data has to be processed frequently, very frequently, like the student's data entering onto the servers, after the student data is entered, data is getting processed on the server and give the responses accordingly and all, they prefer for client server models. Only data exchanges without any processing, then P2P is sufficient. This is well suitable for those things. Yeah. So any other doubts, please? I'm here only. Just go through those things. So one more doubt from Nitin. Yeah, sir. Now, if we have an AI intensive process, there is a P2P system where different models are present in different nodes, and client server model where all the nodes are on the server itself. Which one will be better? If an AI intensive process means you want to put some AI model to be running on your network, Sai? Nitin Sai? I mean, many models are required. Many models mean, say, let me just tell you something like this. See, models means you have to be clear in the models here. The meaning of model in AI is going to be a little bit complex. A model contains many levels of processing the data. Many levels means, if you say convolutional neural network, it has got so many layers. That's why deep neural network. Deep neural networks mean deep. The meaning of deep is more number of hidden layers will be there in the deep neural networks. Similarly, in convolutional neural networks also, there will be intermediate data processing. Data is going to be processed depending on the method, depending on your various parameters that you set. So that is one model only. In that model, you will have different layers, different levels. You mean to say those levels and like one predicting test or one classifying the image. That's what. See, when you are doing this kind of classification or regression techniques that you want to apply, see, it is called as one model itself. So yes, you can do it on the context of P2P or a client server. What happens in the client server is, data, everything is collected and you send the data to the server to process it. where on the server you have a model that is basically client server model. If you want to deploy it on the P2P systems, P2P networks, I told you clearly P2P is basically more advantages for data exchange only, not for processing the data. More data to be processed, no, only exchange data, just whatever data there available on that node, that can be transferred to the requested node. So P2P systems are more grateful, more advantages for the exchange of data, the searching and exchange of data more specifically. Again, when you're looking for processing of the data, client servers data are going to be more useful. But the servers are going to be, because they send that request, if the server cannot process, one server cannot process, again the request is forwarded to another server to get the intermediate or computing results to be made available. So in AI, you can do that. If your logic in your AI model is to have a distributed nature, you can as well do with the client server modeling itself with distributed computing systems. It means you can have multiple servers with a distributed nature. That's what we got cluster computing. There's a name called a cluster computing. There's another technology called Kubernetes. They all go for distributed computing techniques with multiple servers, with multiple data computations. So those things are basically client server models only. P2P system is basically meant for exchange, data downloading, data uploading. That is, data downloading, data uploading is only exchange of data. Please remember. If you want to do like predicting the text, it means data should be computed. Classifying the images means data should be processed, data should be computed. So whenever you do some data processing, data computations, client server is most preferable. Only data to be communicated from one computer to another computer, or from one system to another system, uploading data or downloading the data, only that is the data exchange, then P2P system is most preferable. Whenever computations are required, client server, because there is a depending on the client request, the server has to do the processing accordingly. That's why you prefer for client server. Yeah, any other doubts, please? Yes, combination of two, the network architectures, they have been combined. That's what you see it in the overlay networks. Can we have a combination of these two systems where data is retrieved from video and processed using client server? Yes, people do deploy this kind of architectures for their own. If companies are having to only exchange the data and the processing has to be done, they perform these. You can pass it on. You can, once you collect the data, you can process and pass it on to the other nodes. It's a combination only. Always, if you see the multiple architectures are getting this world heterogeneous computing environments, different architectures are getting connected. If you can remember, I said in one of the meeting, there is a cloud layer also. Actually, client server model is one. Second model is peer-to-peer. The third model is cloud computing model. Even you can just send it to the cloud also. There's another layer. So I don't want to confuse you or not. People always go for combinations of all these things. Yeah, please check your assignment one marks also. I think for one or two students, that evaluation was not completed. So I just like to know if those people are having any problem. And for some of the students, I given the comments why the marks were less. So just go through those marks. If you want to any clarification, you just send me the mails. So by next Friday, we'll complete the assignment two marks also. Just I like to hear from you whether you are able to download the materials and the video files properly from the Moodle website for everyone. Maybe around 20 plus people are there. Increase, yes, all quizzes dates will be extended up to 30th. After this meeting is over, I'll just change those settings now. All quizzes and assignments. There is no, we are not giving a constant. We told clearly those, the deadlines which are given is to make you to be regularly study those materials, means read those materials, understand them and participate in the evaluation process, assessment process. If you give a very long date, people will always, most of them try to respond only in the last minutes. So to avoid that last minute rush-ups only, we want to be irregular. We do those things. That's why those deadlines were given, 2 weeks time for quizzes and assignments were given. That 2 weeks also will be extended now. But don't take it that as an advantage and don't pend your works till the last minute. That's what, because the time will fly away. Since this is in, we are going in an asynchronous mode and this is an online. So you have to be very much, what I call, need to be very much disciplined for yourself. Every week you need to complete certain part of the course. So the usual tendency of the student is quiz, deadline is still there, so we'll always do at the last minute. That attitude, please remove it, then definitely it will be useful for you. Those deadlines will definitely be extended. I'm telling you, they are not very hard deadlines. They are only soft deadlines. So what I mean to hard and soft means, very soft deadlines are very temporary. Hard deadlines are, we need to be strictly following that deadline. That is where the hard deadline is. So these are all soft deadlines only. We will definitely extend. Today I'm going to extend it. You can see that today. Really, I can understand some of the students are having some internet issues and other health problems are there, but please try to cope up. You have to somehow go through the things regularly. So please do read the materials and try to understand them. You can be ask your doubts during our interactive, or you can send me the mails also. Of course, some of you are doing, but only a few of them are regularly having in touch. That's what I can understand. Because we have a class of 80, so at least more people should be interactive one. Indradev, hello sir, where can I check the marks? See, I'm just presenting my screen once again. All of you just look here. Regarding the, of course, your quiz marks will be there with you on your, and assignment marks also will be there only. I'm just presenting it, all of you look onto the screen. So, if you see here, of course, this is because I logged in as a teacher, I can see all your grades. So this is all the grades. Whenever you completed your quiz exams, all your grades, and we usually take the copies of these. So these are all assignment 1 marks which are already being given here. So you can see this is an assignment 1 which is already evaluated. This is it as far as the teacher is concerned. So you can suppose this is who is this? Rupesh Narayan. So this is quiz 1. Depending on the number of attempts, your marks going to be deducted sometimes. This is Sahil. The quiz 1, quiz 2, quiz 3, quiz 4, quiz 5, like this, Akashdeep. These are all the marks of Akashdeep. So yeah, people have, in the first attempt, people are given more attempts. I agree to that one. So these are all transport service. These are all H5P questions. So you are not given any marks for this. So we'll keep it like that only. So in the assignment 1, this is what your assignment 1 marks are there. You can see it on my screen. You can, when you log in, you can see your grade marks. All the students' marks are there here. If you have submitted your assignments, you will get that. Because what I do usually is I export it to the Excel sheet. So like this, we immediately, once your grade items have been exported, what are all the items are there, and I keep a copy of them in my folder. This what on 19th, this 2 days before only I had taken this backup of the grades. So I keep a record of all these things here. So this is assignment 1, the 1 marks, and all the remaining student marks of those different students will have quiz 1, quiz 2, quiz 3. Some of them are attempted, some of them not attempted. And the deadlines will be extended further now. So those who have not made an attempt, you can make an attempt and complete that exercises. Is it okay, Indradev? You log into your system and you will get your marks on the...
Yes, sir.
Yeah. For those people who got some... How do cookies work? What kind of data do they store in the browser? Okay, Amruta, because we thought we'll discuss cookies in the next unit. That's what, as per the syllabus, is cookies and sessions. See, since you asked the doubt, I'd like to clarify you at this moment. So basically, cookies are a small data which is to be stored on your browser. Cookies and sessions, basically, nothing but... some intermediate data that you want to store. Intermediate means some small data like your usernames, sometimes like your passwords, or sometimes like your web page addresses. Of course, those are called bookmarks which you can store here. So if you have a server which is going to be running, what are cookies? Let me tell you, just first understand what are cookies. The most of the time, whenever your request goes from your client to the server, so whenever you means you are from the client, some request goes to the server. That a request information, if it is very small quantity of information, small sizes in terms of KBs, less than KBs only, of course, in terms of bytes. So that kinds of information need not be sent all the time to the server. That small quantities of information can be stored as well on your browser, that is your client application itself. So those cookies are those such kind of information where small, like your usernames or something like the user's information, sometimes you want to store something. So those informations which you are storing on the browser itself, the browser settings will be there, as you can see here. So you have the settings, so you can go to your cookies session, cookies and sessions values can be stored here. Sessions values are something little bit in bigger size than cookies. Cookies occupies less storage, means less quantities of data. Sessions will take more quantities of data. So that I will anyway demonstrate you once PHP is over, that we are going to discuss in the next unit, not now. But the meaning is you might have understood some small quantities of data which can be stored on your client side. That quantities need not all the time go to your server. That is the basic information that keep a track on that one at present. Cookies and sessions are meant for that purpose. I could see, but some of you have not made attempts actually. Remal Dua is not attending our interactive sessions also. Anybody has got any updates about Remal Dua? NCS students, please kindly respond. Mohammed Imran Khan. Last week I talked to this guy, but still he has not made an attempt. The Lal Turanga is also the problem, is from the beginning he is not attending. Rakesh Reddy. Rakesh Reddy is another guy. So like this, some Rajiv Kumar Shakya. So there are 4 to 5 guys who have not made an attempt actually. That is the okay. So actually, sir, I was reading about token-based authentication. So I was wondering how JSON Web Token is different from cookies. See, I'll tell you, see here, Amrita, the thing is JSON has got certain format. Like your attribute value, key value pairs. JSON data is going to be stored as a key value pair. And that JSON Web Token is different from cookies, yes. If you are maintaining that token which contains the authentication, when you say authentication is something like username, user password, user other set of user information will be there, like the place, the country, if you are giving some other attributes with respect to that authentication, those things are all going to be stored under the JSON file. So that JSON file has got the key value pairs, attribute and the corresponding value will be there. So that attribute and the value, that file size is going to be more than your cookie file. Cookies are, I just told you, it is very small files, small data files in terms of less than KBs, not even MBs actually. But JSON files, sometimes your authentication file to have the handshaking process with the server, for that handshaking process to happen correctly with respect to the server file, the JSON file will be more than KB. So anything to be less than KB size only, you're going to consider it to be as a cookie, and that can be stored onto your browser, on your client-side browser only. So if the JSON file web token for authentication, it is going to have a long set of data values. That size is going to be more. That they are, you cannot put it as a cookie. I hope I was able to clarify, Amrita. Yeah, any other doubt, please? So JSON Web Token is not stored on the client side. If you want, you can store it. If you, that settings will be there. All the time, that web tokens can need not be requested from our side all the time. You can set it, but that we, that thing is not called as a cookie. We call it as your JSON file only. That is a category. That is a different categories of files that you can store it on the client side. That thing, the JSON Web Token, we will not call it as a cookie. It is a JSON file, authentication file. So I am just expecting some exercises be submitted here for the these integrated MTech students. It's almost 1 week is over now. So please do practice how to submit it. Every day one exercise is most important. At least one exercise you have to complete. Integrated MTech students. Yeah, any other doubts, please? Okay. Sir, can you use images from the internet where it can be written copyright? Yes, you can use images from the internet, but it is always a good habit. You need to acknowledge them. It is your minimum courtesy to give some credits to them. So you always mention from where you are copied or where you are from, where, from which sources you are using those files. So because if you look to the ethics and the standards, make a habit as a professional yourself need to be very much in a professional way, because our Indian attitude is sometimes Indian people do not acknowledge from the sources where they collect. That's why copyright issues, more things will be there. But I urge all of you to have some kind of professionalism. Yes, this is written subject to copyright. What does it mean? Because somebody has put that statement means you cannot use that for your own purpose, whether it is an image or a text or some material. So you need to get permission from them. Sometimes some people give permissions, whatever they keep it on the web, they can modify. They can modify means they can take that text and they can write their own text. They can change the images. They can change whatever if they give permission to us. But sometimes some people put restrictions. They say that this material cannot be modified or cannot be changed or cannot be deleted or cannot be updated until unless you obtain the copyrights. Means the rights are with somebody else, the owner. The owner of that particular person is the person who has created that document, created that text, created that image. So he is the sole owner of that one. If he gives permission only, you have to, you can change it. That's why there are so many types of copyright laws are there, copyright things are there. Copyright itself is a different, very, so license is another term. So there are so many terms. You will come to know all these things in your software engineering course. What is the exact term you have to use? You cannot use the term copyright here as such. Just for a discussion, you can say the meaning you understood. I can just responding to that meaning. So there is written subject to copyright, yes. That copyrights means there are different versions of copyrights will be there. Sometimes they say only for reading, sometimes they say for reading and writing, sometimes they say for modifying, sometimes they say can they say the customizing, different versions of that. So but what I suggest you is in your assignments or whatever the wherever you are writing from now onwards, have a practice of trying to acknowledge them. That is your minimum courtesy. Because the people who made the images, they spend a lot of time in that one. They put a lot of ideas. They put a lot of energy in that picture preparation. So it is not that simply you take that picture and you tell that, oh, I have taken this. I have done this picture on my own. That's not the purpose. Because you need to give value to the other professionals, their time, their energy, their creativity. Even a simple image. That's why drawings, images. You know how much time it takes for, you know, if you are a painting, you know how much time you are spending for that to draw that paint. And your idea is exhibited in that paint. This is your idea. That is what your thing. That is you own it. Like that somebody has owning that. So you should not steal their things. That's what the ethics comes into picture. That's why they put all these things. Licensing. That's what open license, open source. In our computer terminology or IT terminology, there are so many terms are related. So in a course like software engineering, you will come across all those things. What are the copies? What are called copyrights? What are called licenses? What are called laws? And so on and so forth. Yeah, Tarun. Yes. Good question, actually, you asked it. Because when we write research papers and all, when we write books, chapters, books and all, so we also have to be taken care. And whenever we keep some material on this public websites, like on this Moodle website, because others are also seeing that one. That's why sometimes we may use some people's slides, some people's material. So we need to acknowledge that. That's why we'll say from where we are using those materials. We provide as a reference. You provide under the below the slide itself, you provide, or before the beginning of the presentation, we'll tell what type of license was given from those authors and what we have done that one. Or sometimes we don't give anything, means we have prepared on our own. That's what. Even our slides, if there is nothing like that, we are not taken from any sources, means we have prepared on our own. So, professional, these are all professional ethics. It's always good to know yourself and to be aware of. Because in India, anything can be managed, but when you go to the Western country, these things, Western side and Europe, these to be very strictly followed. So you need to be very careful. So please have an habit of not just simply copying. If you want to take some sources, you please acknowledge the source properly. That will be most good way. That will be better. I'm sorry for the today. We just started a little late. Problem with my internet connection over here. That's why I could not start it properly. Some of you have sent messages. Yeah. Sir, I was submitting a lesson, but marks not given. That's what one or two students, actually, I was evaluating, I could just put the marks. So, Mutaz is one candidate, yeah. I'll just complete them now. After the session is over, I'll complete that evaluation. Assignment man, more or less, almost 70 plus students have put the screenshots and they're able to understand what is dig and all. But some of them dig space any was not done. I don't know. Some of the majority of the students are able to complete it for a dig any. Of course, dig is not a very big command or not a big tool or utility, but nevertheless, you'll understand there is something related to DNS. That is just an introductory topic and a tool for you. But try to understand this HTTP properly, all of you. HTTP, the versions of HTTP, and what does HTTP is doing. Yeah, any other doubts, please? I'm online only.